Hello viewers, welcome to UN Digital Class. In today's lecture, I am going to discuss about Prolog programming. Let us start. First of all, what is Prolog? Prolog, as the name itself suggests, it is the short form of logical programming. And it is a logical and declarative programming language. That means here, Prolog programming is nothing but it is a logical programming language. It also uses the declarative programming language. Next, before going to the Prolog programming, first of all, we have to know about what is logical programming. Logical programming is one of the computer programming paradigm in which the program statements express the facts and rules about different problems within a system of formal logic. That means, here, logical programming is nothing but it is a programming language which takes the statements as the facts and it uses some rules to represent that facts into a logic. Next, here the rules are written in the form of logical clauses where head and body are present. That means, in logical programming language, we basically use the facts and rules. And here the rules are written in the form by using some logical clauses, where these logical clauses uses head and body. Next, one example of a logical programming. Here, capital H is head and B1, B2, B3 are the elements of the body. Now, if you state that H is true, that means B1, B2, B3 all are true. This is a rule. Which means, in this example, we are taking H is the head and B1, B2, B3 are the elements of the body. If we say that H is true, that means it implies that the body B1, B2, B3 also true. This is called a rule. Next, on the other hand, facts are like the rules but without any body. So, an example of fact is H is true. That means, here, fact is nothing but it is also a rule. But here, there is no body. When a rule without no body, then we can say that it is a fact. For example, you can say that H is true. That means, here, this specifies a fact. Next, look at this figure. This figure shows the difference between logical programming and functional programming. Here, the logical programming always uses the knowledge base. That means here this knowledge base is nothing but that this works as a database from which the machine takes the information or takes the answer according to the question. Then it gives the answer to the user. But in our functional programming language, simply we uses the different procedures to take the input and give the output. This is the main difference between the logical programming and the functional programming. Next, we can see that in functional programming, we have to define the procedure and the rule how the procedure works. These procedures work step by step to solve one specific problem based on the algorithm. But in other hand, for the logic programming, we will provide knowledge base. Using this knowledge base, the machine can find the answer to the given question, which is totally different from the functional programming language. That means, here, the difference between functional programming and logical programming is that the functional programming always takes the procedure to take input from the system. And then it uses the procedure to define how to process this input and produce the output. But in our logical programming language, there is one knowledge base. From this knowledge base, the machine retrieves the answer of the question asked by the user. Then it gives the answer to the user by retrieving the knowledge base information. Next, in functional programming, we have to mention how one problem can be solved. But in logical programming, we have to specify for which problem we actually want the solution. That means this difference says that in functional programming language, we say that which problem we want to solve and how to solve. But in logical programming language, we define which problem we have to solve. Then next, the logic programming automatically finds a suitable solution that will help us to solve the specific problem. Here, the logical programming always says that which problem we have to solve. Then it automatically finds a solution and provides the answer. Next, what is prologue? Prologue or programming in logic is a logical and declarative programming language. It is one major example of the fourth generation language that supports the declarative programming paradigm. That means, I have already told you, prologue is nothing but it is a logical programming language, which basically uses the declarative programming paradigm. Next, this is particularly suitable for programs that involve symbolic or non-numeric computation. And this is the main reason to use prologue as the programming language in artificial intelligence, where symbol manipulation and inference manipulations are the fundamental tasks. That means the prologue programming is basically used for the symbolic and non-numeric programs. But in our artificial intelligence, there is so many symbols and inference rules which we have used. For this reason, this prologue programming language is basically used for our artificial intelligence. Next, in prologue, we need not mention the way how one problem can be solved. We just need to mention what the problem is, so that the prologue automatically solves it. That means, in prologue programming language, we only specify which problem we have to solve. We don't specify how to solve that problem, but the prologue automatically solves that problem. Next, prologue language basically has three different elements. First one is the facts. The fact is predicate that is true. For example, if we say Tom is the son of Jack, then this is a fact. That means here, fact is nothing but it is a predicate, which is always true. If you are taking a sentence that is Tom is a father of Jack, and this statement is true, then we can say that this is a fact. Then next, rules. Here, rules are extensions of facts that contains conditional clauses. To satisfy a rule, these conditions should be met. Now take one example. If we define a rule as grandfather of XY, that implies father of XZ and parent ZY, which means it says that for X to be the grandfather of Y, Z should be parent of Y and X should be father of Z. And this is nothing but this is the rule. Next, questions. To run a prologue program, we need some questions. And those questions can be answered by the given facts and the rules. That means, in our prologue programming language, we have to always give a question, and that question must be answered by using the given facts and rules. And this answer must be retrieved from the knowledge base. Next, facts. Here, we can define fact as an explicit relationship between objects and properties of these objects might have. So, facts are unconditional true in nature. Suppose we have some facts are given below. Here, the first fact is Tom is a cat. And this is true. That means we can say that it is a fact. Next, Kunal loves to eat pasta. Then next one is hair is black. And next, Noah loves to play games. And last one is Pratyush is lazy. That means here, More precisely, we can say that fact is nothing but it is a relationship between the object and their properties. And fact is always true by nature. Suppose you are taking some example, that is Tom is a cat. If this statement is true, then we can say that this is a fact. Next, following are some guidelines to write facts. First guideline is names of properties or relationships begin with lowercase letters. That means when we are writing a facts, in that fact, the properties and relationships must be begin with a lowercase letters. The next rule is the relationship name appears as the first term, which means when you are writing a fact, the first term must be a relationship. Next is objects appear as comma separated arguments within parentheses. That means within the bracket, we can write the objects which are separated by comma. These are the some guidelines of writing facts. Next guideline is a period, that is the dot symbol, must end a fact. Next one is objects also begins with lowercase letters. They also can begin with digits and can be string of character enclosed in quotes. That means when we write an object in our fact, that object must be begin with a lowercase letter and that object may be start with a digit or maybe it consists of some characters enclosed with quotes. Now take one example. In this example, color is the relationship and here pen, ink and red. Here red is nothing but this is one object which is enclosed within quotes. Next example is phone number. Here this phone number is nothing but this is the relationship or properties. And here these two are the object and it is also called a predicate or clause. These are the different guidelines for writing a facts. Next, syntax of facts. The syntax for fact is follows. Now look at here, the relation, then bracket, within the bracket object 1 comma object 2 up to the object n. That means when you are writing a fact must be start with a relationship name and the relationship name must be start with a lowercase letter. Then we give the bracket and within the bracket we write the different object names and these object names are separated by comma. And here the object name may also start with the digit or character. This is the syntax of writing a fact. Now take some example. Here following are some example of the fact. That is cat Tom. That means here cat is nothing but this is the relation and Tom is nothing but this is the object. In this way loves to eat Kunal pasta, which means Kunal loves to eat pasta. And here loves to eat is nothing but this is the relationship name. And Kunal pasta, these two are the object. Next one is the of color, hair black. That means hair color is black. Here of color is the relationship and hair black, these two are the object. Then next one is the loves to play games, Nawaz. That means Nawaz loves to play games. Here, loves to play games is nothing but this is the relationship name and Nawaz is nothing but this is the object. Then last one is lazy Pratyush. That means Pratyush is lazy. Here, lazy is the relationship name and Pratyush is the object name. In this way, we can represent the normal English sentence into our fact. Next is the rules. Here we can define rule as an implicit relationship between objects. So facts are conditional true. So when one associated condition is true, then the predicate is also true. Suppose we have take some rules as given below. That is, Lily is happy if she dances. Then next rule is Tom is hungry if he is searching for food. The next, Jack and Billy are friends if both of them love to play cricket. And last rule is Rayan will go to play if school is closed and he is free. That means here rule is nothing but it is the implicit relationship between the objects. Now look at how we represent a rule by using the syntax of our prologue programming. Here these are some rules that are conditional true. So when the right hand side is true, then the left hand side is also true. That means when we are writing some rule and in that rule the right hand side is true, that means it specifies that the left hand side also true. Then next, here the symbol. This is the symbol which will be pronounced as if or is implied by. This is also known as neck symbol. The LHS of this symbol is called the head and the right hand side of this symbol is called the body. That means when we are writing a rule by using this symbol is specifies the head and body. And here the left hand side of this symbol is nothing but that is the head and the right hand side of this symbol is nothing but that is the body. Next, here we can use comma which is known as conjunction and we can also use semicolon that is known as disjunction. Now look at the syntax of rule. Here rule name, that means here we write our rule name, then we give the object name, that is object 1, object 2, then this is the symbol, we can say it as if. Then we write our fact or rule, then next object 1, object 2. In this way, we can represent our rule. Suppose, take one example, that is P, if Q, then this semicolon represents the disjunction. Then R, this can also be written as P implies by Q or P implies by R. Because here this semicolon represents the disjunction, so that we can write this rule as P implies Q and P implies R. Then next one, if one clause is like that is P implies Q comma R, then semicolon, then S comma T comma U, then this rule can be written as P implies Q comma R within the bracket, then semicolon, then S comma T, then comma U. Because here this Q R is disjuncted from the S T U. Or we can write this formula as P implies Q comma R, then next P implies S comma T comma U. This is the rule for writing a formula. Look at this sentence, that is Lily is happy if she dances. Now we represent this rule by using our prologue rule syntax. Here this is the syntax, that is happy Lily implies dance Lily. Next one is the hungry Tom implies search for food Tom. Then next, friends Jack Billy implies loves cricket Jack. Then this comma operator represents the conjunction, that is the and, loves cricket Billy. Then next one is the go to play Rayan implies is closed school comma free Rayan. That means in this way we can write our rules by using the syntax of prologue rules. Then next one is the queries. Here queries are sub questions on the relationship between objects and the object properties. So question can be anything. Now look at the example, that is Tom a cat and does Kunal loves to eat pasta? Is Lily happy? Will Rayan go to play? So according to these queries, logical programming language can find the answer and then return them. That means here in Prolog programming language, query is nothing but that is the relationship between the objects and their properties. And in this programming language, always the user asks a query and the machine takes this query as input, and according to that query, it retrieves the information from the knowledge base, then it gives answer to that user. This is the introduction to Prolog programming language. Here, you must remember that Prolog programming language is nothing but it is a logical programming language. And basically, this programming language is used in our artificial intelligence. If you have any doubt regarding this introduction to Prolog programming language, then you can ask me with a comment. I will reply you and discuss about your doubt. Thank you for watching.